Okay, yes. So let's revise that
yes,
part.
Yes, ma'am, we will discuss.
Yes, revise that part and then we will start solutions and solubility. So what is condensation? After evaporation, if we just heat up the water, then what will happen? If we increase the temperature, at high temperature, water always evaporates. That means water converts into what? The gaseous form of water, that is water vapor. And as water vapor is the gaseous form of water, it always tends to go to the upward direction because gases are very light by their weight. This process is called evaporation. That means the conversion of water into water vapor at high temperature. That is called evaporation. Now, if we just put a lid or if we are able to just hold any lid or any kind of substance on the water vapor that is produced due to the evaporation, then what will happen is the water vapor will cool down and again it will turn back to the water droplets. Now this process is known as condensation. So when water vapor is converted to water droplets again at low temperature, that is called condensation. So evaporation and condensation are completely opposite methods. For evaporation, we need high temperature. For condensation, we need to cool down the water vapor. So the condition is low temperature. Okay. So now you look here in this part from your book that I'm marking. Here, we will have to read about solutions and solubility. For that, we must know that what are solutes and what are solvents, right? So who will tell me what are solutes? If anyone knows this answer, raise your hand. You have learned it in your previous class also. This is why I'm asking this. Okay, say Aryan Hussain. Yes, Aryan. Unmute your device and tell it.
Ma'am, water is solvent and salt is solute.
Okay, that is absolutely correct answer. If we are dissolving salt into, we have dissolved salt into water and made a salt water mixture, then in that case, so the substance that we are adding into solvent, that is called the solute. So if we have made a salt water solution, then the salt will be called the solute. And the liquid into which we are adding that solute, that liquid will be called the solvent. In case of the salt water solution, water is the solvent. So the substance that is added to the solvent, that is called solute, and the liquid into which we add the solute, that is called the solvent. Now this is a common formula. You can see I'm writing here on the screen that I have also told you yesterday this one. Solvent plus solute. Solvent plus solute makes the solution. Mute your device and see from whose device that noise is coming. You mute your device. Solvent plus solute makes the solution. A solution is a homogeneous mixture of a solvent and a solute. The substance that dissolves in the liquid, that is called the solute, and the liquid which the solute is been dissolved, that is called the solvent. For example, here in your book, it is given as sugar water solution. In a sugar solution, sugar is the solute and water is the solvent. All the substances do not form the solutions. Only soluble substances form the solutions. If the substances are soluble, then only solutions can be made. Like sugar, salt, all these substances are soluble. But what will happen if we take sand or chalk dust? Will they dissolve in water? No, they will not dissolve in water. The sand particles will settle down at the bottom of the glass, right? They will not dissolve in water. And the chalk particles, chalk dust, they will float on the surface of the water, right? So they will not dissolve. So they will not make the solution. So, yes, who is this? Jahid. Yes, Jahid.
Ma'am, chalk powder can be soluted in water.
No, chalk powder will not dissolve in water. Yes, if the chalk dust will not dissolve in water, if it is powder form, yes, if it is in the powder form, then you might see that the water has turned white, right? But actually the chalk particles will not dissolve in water. If you are taking chalk powder, then some of it may dissolve, okay, if you are taking it in the powder form. But the chalk particles, they will never dissolve in water. Okay?
Okay,
only soluble substances can form the solutions. Substances like salt, sugar, they dissolve in water. So they are soluble substances. They are soluble in water. Substances like chalk, sand, they do not dissolve in water. So they are called insoluble substances, or they will be called, they are insoluble in water. If we keep adding teaspoon of sugar into water and stir the solution each time, what will happen after some time? We will see that particles of sugar are settled at the bottom of the solution. This shows that no more sugar can be dissolved. We can say that the solution has become saturated. So what happens if you have taken a glass of water, and continuously you are just adding sugar to it. You can take salt also. Continuously you are adding the sugar to it and stirring it. It is getting dissolved. After some time, if you continuously add sugar to it, after some time you will see that the sugar is not dissolving in the water. Just like other insoluble substances, it is settling down at the bottom of the glass. So now the solution will be called a saturated solution, because the solution in the water, there is a capacity of a particular quantity of water, not only water, of all the solvents, to dissolve the solutes. Okay, so as much sugar that one glass water could dissolve in it, it has dissolved. Now the extra sugar that you are adding, it cannot dissolve. It cannot be dissolved. So the sugar will settle down at the bottom of the glass. So this type of solutions that cannot dissolve more solutes, these types of solutions are called saturated solutions. Now go to the next page. A solution when reached the maximum solubility is called the saturated solution. Maximum solubility means when it has reached the maximum solubility, after this, it cannot dissolve any more solute in it. However, if you now heat the glass, you will find that more sugar can be dissolved. So saturated solution cannot dissolve more solutes in it. But if you heat the solution, you will see that some more sugar can be dissolved into the same quantity of water. We can say that the solubility of sugar in water increases with temperature. So from this activity, we can determine that the solubility of the sugar has increased due to the increase in the temperature. The solubility of most substances in water increases with temperature. Now I can see two hands are raised here. Yes, Srijan, Srijan, you have raised your hand. Yes, Srijan.
Yes, ma'am. I raised my hand, ma'am. When you asked the question, ma'am, I forgot.
Okay, wanted to tell the answer then. This is why. Okay. And Prajakta Sharkar. Prajakta, you also raised your hand.
Yes, ma'am. In solution and solubility, there is one written that particles. And saturated, it is means that saturated means mix in water.
No, saturated solution means the solution cannot dissolve any more solute particle. So if you have taken one glass of water and you have added too much of sugar in it, and after some time you will see that, suppose after 5 minutes, you will see that the glass is, in that glass of water, you cannot dissolve any more sugar. Though we all know that sugar is soluble in water, but you have added too much of sugar, and now the sugar that you are adding, it cannot be dissolved. So the sugar will settle down because it is called the saturated solution, because it has reached the maximum solubility. the water also has a power or ability to dissolve the solutes, right? The amount of water that you have used, it has dissolved maximum amount of sugar that it could dissolve in it, or the solubility of sugar also we can say. So the amount, if you add more water to it, then you will be able to dissolve more sugar. Am I clear to you? The amount of the if you have taken one glass of water, so it has a particular amount of sugar only can be dissolved in it. After that, no more sugar cannot be dissolved in it. But if you increase the temperature, if you just heat that solution, sugar water solution, then the solubility of sugar increases with the temperature. If you heat that solution, you will be able to add few more teaspoons of sugar to the water solution, to the sugar solution. Okay. So if you heat that solution, you will be able to add few more teaspoons of sugar into it. So that is called saturated solution, when the solution reaches its maximum solubility, and after that it cannot dissolve any more solute particle. And if you have a saturated solution, but still you want to add or dissolve few more teaspoons of sugar into it, so what you will have to do, you just simply heat the solution. If you heat the solution, the solubility of that solute particle will increase, and you will be able to add few more teaspoons of sugar into it. Now the next part is importance of water as solvent. Okay, this question is very important question for 5 marks. You can see you will have to draw this and you will have to write this answer. 3+2 is the mark division for this type of question generally. So importance of water as a solvent, everyone mark it as very, very important. This is very important question. Water is a universal solvent because it can dissolve a large number of substances in it. Water is essential to our body in the process of digestion. Several waste materials in our body get dissolved in water and are then excreted. So all the toxic materials and waste materials that we excrete or that we remove from our body, that we eliminate from our body, we eliminate it in the form of water, right? With our urine, a lot of water is there mixed with those toxic waste materials. And when we sweat, in that way also we eliminate some toxic materials from our body. And that is also a form of, in the form of water. Sweat is also a form of water. So this is how, and blood, all the important nutrients and all the enzymes and nutrients, whatever is needed in different parts of our body, they are carried through the blood, right? And maximum part of our blood is also made up of water. So this is why water is very important. The number of chemical reactions occur inside our body, they all occur in the presence of water only. You all know, not only in our body, in plant body also, without water, plants cannot perform photosynthesis, right? They perform photosynthesis with the help of carbon dioxide and water. So if not enough water is there, so plants will not be able to make their foods inside their body, or they will not be able to photosynthesize. In plants, water helps to transport nutrients also. So the food that the plant has made by the process of photosynthesis, it needs to transport the nutrient or transport the food to all the other parts of the plant body. Who transports it? Water. So all those foods and nutrients, they are dissolved in water, and through water they are transported to all the parts of the plant body. And since water is a good solvent and it can dissolve various minerals and salts in it, gases such as oxygen and carbon dioxide, which are soluble in water, are important for survival of aquatic life. Aquatic life means the fishes and the plants, animals and the plants that live in water. They are called aquatic animals and aquatic plants. for them also, water, the carbon dioxide and oxygen that they need, that is dissolved in water. Fish breathe in oxygen dissolved in water through their gills. Aquatic plants use the carbon dioxide that is dissolved in water for photosynthesis. The solubility of gases in water decreases with increase in temperature. Thus, dissolved gases escape from water when it is heated. So the solubility of gases, so gases like carbon dioxide and oxygen, they are soluble in water, but their solubility decreases with the increase in the temperature. So if you heat the water or boil the water, even boil the water, what happens? All the gases that are dissolved in the water, they will escape from the water. So if you increase the temperature, the amount of gases dissolved in water, that will decrease. And if you decrease the temperature, make the lower the temperature, then the amount of gases that are dissolved in water, they will not escape, they will stay there. Okay. So this is why water is very, very important for all the animals and plants. Okay. Now I'm giving you 1 minute, read this part. And if any problem, any doubt is there, you tell me.
Ma'am.
First of all, you read this part, okay? So part A, fill in the blanks. The liquid above the dash is known as the supernatant
liquid. Sediment.
The clear liquid obtained after dash is called the
filtration. Filtration.
Gas water is used in laboratory.
Distilled water.
Distillation is done by setting
apparatus.
Okay. Now sometimes threshing is done with the help of
blocks.
Gas liquids can be separated
invisible.
To immiscible liquids. Yes. The process of conversion of water into water vapor.
Evaporation.
Very good. The solubility of gases in water.
Temperature.
Very good. All the answers are correct. So I'm showing you all the answers. So the students who are writing, you write the answers. The first answer will be sediment. Second answer will be filtration. Third answer will be distilled. The fourth answer will be apparatus. Fifth answer will be bullocks. The sixth answer will be immiscible. The seventh answer will be evaporation. And the eighth answer will be temperature. Mahir Hussain, you want to tell me anything?